Hello everyone, this is Shoham Mitro and today I'm back with another podcast. Apologies to everyone cause it's been a long time. I haven't posted any podcast on my channel, but trust me, today's podcast is really special. Today's podcast is about a debut novel written by Shonak Chatterjee. So, hi Shonak, how are you doing?
Hey Shom, and thanks for inviting me once again in your podcast, and I hope we're going to have a great conversation.
Yeah, exactly. So first of all, congratulations on this big achievement, Shonak. We all are proud of you. So I had a few questions to ask you. So let's begin. Okay, so Shonak, how it all started? Like, I knew that you were into short stories and you have written like quite a few of them as well. But how did this idea of writing down a novel came up to your mind? So how this thing happened?
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I was into storytelling for quite some time now, but nobody was aware that I was writing a novel. Actually, it started almost 4 years back, and I was never into writing. I was more into reading. And then the thing happened that while reading one of the novels of my favorite author, like it happened yesterday, that is a novel by Ravindra Singh, and which tells a lot about his childhood. That is the story that motivated me a lot to write my own story. That is the story that made me feel that I should also write mine. And at the same time, somewhere I also wanted to save the memories that I made as a that I created during my childhood days, because the thing is that maybe today we are here, but maybe 50 years or 60 years from now, we are not going to stay in this world anymore. We'll suddenly disappear, but our stories will remain. People will still continue to read our stories, and that is from where that I got the idea. And in the novel also, the story that made me in that novel, it is also mentioned at the end that after reading those books, actually I started penning down my own story. At the beginning, it was like a journal. I never thought of publishing it or turning it into a novel. But with time and with more time, ideas kept coming in, and finally, I decided that I should go ahead and get it published and let the world know our story.
Oh, exactly. That's great. My next question to you is, like, you know, on what level do you connect with your book, with your novel? So what's the level of connection that you have, like, while writing it down? What were the thoughts that were going in your mind and after it got published? So what is the connection right now?
See, writing is a big process. It doesn't happen in one day. It took me almost 4 years to jot down just around 40,000 words. So it was, I will say, the journey was great. And there were times when I had my writer's block. I couldn't write any farther. There were nights when I thought about writing a lot, but I ended up writing only a paragraph. Well, there were nights when I wrote 2 to 3 chapters. And for now, the feeling, to be honest, the feeling is good. It feels great to get published after so much of hard work, after so many rejections from the topmost publishers of India. But yeah, the feeling is great. But the thing that is making me more happy, me feel more great, is when someone is reading my book and sending their reviews, and I see that in more than criticism, I can see they are returning with a very good review, and that is what making me feel good.
That's great indeed. Like, you know, obviously I haven't read your book yet, but still I know it's gonna be a massive hit. So after hearing how it all started and how deeply you are connected to this novel, would you like to share a bit more about your novel, Shonak?
Yeah, that would be great. Obviously, I will prefer people to read my story. But a part of it I would love to share. I'm sharing the blurb from The Story That Made Me, and hear it how it goes. When Varudh completed reading the novel of his favorite author, he had the sudden urge to write a story from his life that had just passed by. His school life was ending, and he knew the days which he enjoyed the most will never return again. He will never again wait ecstatically outside his house, eagerly waiting for the pool car to meet his friends. He will no longer carry his cricket bat to school on every Saturday. He will never have to worry and study for long hours before the exam. His commutes will be quiet and lonesome, and no more made of laughters and happiness. He will fall in love again, and maybe again, but he will miss the innocence of being in love for the first time. He will no longer be in that classroom in the same clothes, just like his friends, and listening to his favorite teacher. Thus he decided to save the memories for a lifetime. Memories made of happiness, success, failure, rejections, friendship, agony, and innocence.
That was mesmerizing, and indeed after hearing this, I can't wait to get your novel in my hands and read it all over. I know that you are an IT guy. Okay, so being an IT guy and a writer at the same time, so what was the main thing, like how you used to manage time? So that is one thing which was really important, right? So how you used to do that?
To be honest, when I wrote this novel, I was in college. I was not working for any organization. But yeah, at this moment I'm working and I'm still writing. Maybe you'll find a sequel maybe 2 years from now. I don't know when I will be able to complete it. But yeah, it's all about the weekend actually. Means it is all about balancing your weekend and finding time in your weekend to just put down your thoughts in a paper. And that is what I'm doing.
Okay, so yeah, definitely I'll be eagerly waiting for the sequel, no doubt about the fact. But so Shonam, do you have any upcoming ideas like for the next novel or something that you have in mind, or any short story as well?
I'm not sure, maybe the sequel that I'm planning, maybe it will be let's see, not sure. Writing is in progress, there are ideas, but I'm not going to reveal them as at this moment.
Okay, so you're gonna keep it a secret. Okay, we'll see.
Yeah.
Okay, so just for you, like, who has actually finally published a novel after so much of hard work and dedication, no doubt about the fact, do you have any advice for the upcoming writers who are planning to publish a novel or a book like in the near future, and those who are inspired, like actually after reading your novel? So what is your advice to them?
I think my advice is going to be same like all the best authors of India. That is, the first step should be, you shouldn't think about publishing. You should write because you love writing, because you want to change, put your thoughts into a piece of paper. That should be the first step. And second, yeah, when you are sending, it's really difficult, to be honest, to get published in India. And if you really want that, do not give up. Have some patience, because it will take time. It will not happen in a span of a 1 month or a 1 year. It may take years to get your book published. But keep believe in yourself. Have faith. And more importantly, whenever you are sending your first draft, make sure that you are 100% sure that you're sending your best writings.
Okay. So that was all. So guys, that was all for today's podcast. And thank you so much, Shonak, for being here. Okay. So, and one of the most important thing that I'm going to tell you all is that, like, you know, I'm giving the link of the book in the description. Okay. Please go check out my channel description. You'll get the link, order the book, read it, and give reviews on Amazon. I bet you guys are gonna love it. And Shonak, we'll be waiting for the sequel soon. Thank you so much. We'll be bringing you in another podcast very soon. And congratulations once again.
Thanks a lot.